Hello and welcome in this video, or we will realize this kitchen with bar in less than 20 minutes. To meet this challenge, we will use SketchUp and the tool offered by the Click Kitchen 2 extension. Although this is not mandatory, it is advisable to study at our project on a blank page before starting or starting small tiles, because a tile corresponds to 10 centimeters for a ladder to a 20th. So it's easy to draw a project to scale, without the risk of making mistakes. To save your file before starting your project is a good reflex to take. Now go to the File menu and Import. Go to the folder where your sketch is, and click on Import. With a simple click, place your image in your 3D scene, and give a scale whatever. Then select the measurement tool. Click to indicate the beginning of your wall. Then a second click to indicate the end of your wall. Now enter the actual length on the keyboard. Then click Yes to scale. We will use the Rectangle tool in order to draw the outlines of our walls. Then, turn on Transparency mode to draw interior walls. Choose the Selection tool and click on the faces and edges to delete, with the Delete key on your keyboard. And trace the openings of your doors and windows using the Line tool. Finally, disable the transparency mode. Select now the pull tool. Place yourself on top of one side and pull up to extrude it. Then give a height to the keyboard to finish validate with the key enter. Draw the transoms using the rectangle tool. Select the face, if it is reversed then right click and go to reverse the face. Then, use the push-pull tool to give a height to your transom. Finally, delete unnecessary lines. Once your walls are done, make a triple left-click to select all. Then right-click and go to the options Create a Group. We will use the extension, Click Window 3D to realize the two windows doors. The free version of this extension offers sliding windows and sliding windows doors. The LT or Pro version offers all categories of windows and doors windows, with an exceptional level of details and options. For more information on this extension, please visit the official website. We will start by importing the corner cabinet. It will serve as a reference to correctly align all other furniture. Then we go place the column cabinet for oven. It is simple now to import and position all the rows of low furniture. Finally, select all the furniture to align with the corner cabinet. Now import the sink cabinet. Then, use the rotate tool to rotate the furniture by 90 degrees. Now you can start the second row of furniture. Move your sink cabinet to the right by pressing the Control key on your keyboard to activate the copy function. With cell mode from the Pro version of Click Kitchen 2, you can replace any piece of furniture with another. With the Pro version, you'll also have a quick resize tool. Before starting the top furniture row, it is important to disable the cell mode. Thanks to the low furniture hanging system, easily place the wall cabinets. Let's start now, the bar furniture. In order to have access to the kitchen side bar furniture, apply a 180 degrees rotation. Now place your first piece of furniture, then make two copies. Imported now, the dining table. Remember to apply a 180 degrees rotation. Then make a right click and go back on the red axis. On the Dynamic Components toolbar provided by SketchUp, click Component Options. With this window, you can now customize the height of your table. Then use the scale tool to stretch your table to the right length. Move now, your furniture 13 mm. Value corresponds to the thickness of the cladding panels, which will be imported later. Now select all the furniture that needs cover panels. Then click on the panels icon. You can now use the small hand to display the panels. To display the deco strip, you have to make a supplementary click on the covers panels. When all the finishes are displayed, you can disable the panels mode. Now select the furniture, which needs a wall cladding. You can then display a backsplash or a wall covering, tiled type. You can change the coating by clicking on the icon of the materials. We are now going to finalize our bar. Apply a rotation of 180 degrees so that the bar shelf bar is in the right direction. Thanks to the hooks, you can easily position the tablet of your bar. Then use the scale tool to adjust the length. If you keep your bar selected, additional options are available by clicking on the bar icon. Let's take a look at other equipment offered by click change to. For example, the hob. Click on the icon several times to choose your model. Do the same thing to choose a fume hood. Same for the faucet. As the goal of this video is to quickly realize a virtual kitchen, we propose you to discover by yourself the many equipment and materials available. Now we can hide our construction sketch. Then, draw the floor of the kitchen. Click on the paint bucket icon to display the materials window. The small plus allows to create a new materials. Then, click on the folder icon to load an image. You can then define the display dimension of the image. With a single click, apply new materials to the floor. We will now see one of the main functions proposed by ClickKitchen 2. Click the thumbnails icon to see all the furniture options. Each miniature represents a reference of furniture available in 3D for this low furniture. Then with a single click on the thumbnail 5, you select the furniture reference with two drawers. Then click on Apply to transform the furniture. When your furniture is the right size and offers the model you want, you can disable the thumbnails. You will quickly notice that each piece of furniture offers a series of furniture specific to this category. We will again use Click Change 2 to choose our handle models. As with all other equipment, you can change the handles with a single click. To change the position of the handles, use the small hand. Then click on the handle of your furniture. To avoid unnecessarily prolonging this video, we will equip our kitchen with Click Change 2, in music and in quick reading. Let's go! Let's not forget now to convert the soil into a group. In order to offer a more detailed 3D kitchen, we will also draw baseboards on the floor. As for the walls, make a triple click to select all the faces and edges of the plinth. Hold down the Control key to add the other plinth to the selection. Then, make a group. To finalize this kitchen, we will see some options available in Pro version. Select your furniture and click on the parametric options icon. This window has many parameters, which we will explain in a next video. Let's see for the moment the setting of the shelves. in order to equip our kitchen for the future made realistic. Use the option of Click Kitchen 2 Pro for importing decorations. For performance reasons, we recommend enabling this option only for your 3D rendering. We will now see some display options. You can hide the fittings, worktops, and also, all the furniture hangers. Now we will discover the toolbar of the materials. The first icon allows to change the materials of facades, cover panels and deco strip for all the furniture. Each click offers a different material, from a catalog of 28 colors and wood species. The following icon displays more than 50 work plans. You see in this example that a sample of existing materials with Click Kitchen 2. You can also choose to display a furniture structure in black or stay on a structure, white melamine. Another materials that we can change is the cover panels and deco strips. This is also valid for skirting boards. With the Pro version of Click Kitchen 2, you can change the materials for a single piece of furniture, as long as you activate the cell mode. A window of information comes to inform you that this mode needs to create new materials to work. Click Yes to validate. Select one or more furniture to customize. Then click on one of the material icons to apply an individual material to the selection. After double-clicking on your furniture, you can select a drawer to apply an individual material. We will not make any other demonstrations of this function to avoid prolonging this video unnecessarily. If you want to restore the materials, a good tip is to activate the thumbnails. You can then disable them with a second click on the icon. We are back in our kitchen with the basic materials. During the video cut, we took the opportunity to change the high cabinet for oven and high cabinet for microwave with the thumbnails. Now we all added a ceiling to our room, a forgotten deco strip on a wall cabinet, and a stencil bar on the wall which we uploaded to the 3D warehouse. After a simple 3D rendering with Renderin, we got this image. There are many realistic rendering engines for SketchUp, some are free, and some are paid. With a simple search on the internet you will probably find the one you need. We hope you like this video. If so, do not hesitate to encourage us by clicking on I like. Thank you for following this video tutorial. We wish you all a great success in your projects. See you soon for new videos.